You know what you're listening to? You're listening to the Deen Team, bringing the light of Islam right into your hearts.
Follow us on Facebook at the Deen Team Sydney radio program and subscribe to our YouTube channel, Deen Team Sydney.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Our dear listeners, welcome to the program, another episode on the Deen Team with you today, your brother in Islam, Malaz Majani. And we want to talk about something important today. In fact, we want to talk about a miracle. You see, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Musa his miracle, the ability to change his stick or his staff into a snake, and the ability to split the ocean, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him this miracle at a time when magic was prevalent. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Isa alayhi salam the ability to cure the blind and to raise people from the dead, He gave it to him at a time when medicine was becoming prevalent and prominent. And subhanAllah, you find when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the biggest miracle, the Holy Qur'an, He gave it to him at a time when the people of Quraysh were very literate and they were very eloquent in speech. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala challenged them with this Qur'an. He said, فَأْتُوا بِعَشْرِ سُوَرِ مِثْلِهِ. Come up with 10 chapters like it. And then they couldn't. And then he came up with another challenge to them. He said, فَأْتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِنْ مِثْلِهِ. Come up with one chapter if you can. But none of them could. And subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us and told them, قُلْ لَإِنِ اجْتَمَعَتِ الْإِنسُ وَالْجِنُّ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَأْتُوا بِمِثْلِ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ لَا يَأْتُونَ بِمِثْلِهِ وَلَوْ كَانَ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ ظَهِيرًا. Say, if mankind and the jinn came together from the time of Adam until the time of the day of judgment, and they came together and worked together to produce a Qur'an like this, they could not produce it, even if they were to assist each other. So subhanAllah, my dear brothers, you find that there's many sisters in Islam. You find that there are many attempts. There's been many attempts to copy and make chapters like the Qur'an. And we all know of Musaylam al-Kadhab and his pathetic attempts to make surah like the Qur'an. And even in our modern day, you find that there's been attempts to make some changes to the Qur'an. However, you find that a young child is able to pick up on an error. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظٌ. That indeed, it is we who send down the Qur'an, and indeed, we will be its guardian. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has protected this book. And this book, my dear brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, He says, لَوْ أَنزَلْنَا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ عَلَى جَبَلٍ لَرَأَيْتَهُ خَاشِعًا مُتَصَدِّعًا مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ. وَتِلْكَ الْأَمْثَالُ نَضْرِبُهَا لِلَّاسِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. That had we sent down this Qur'an upon a mountain, you would have seen this mountain be humbled and crumble apart from the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these are examples that we present to the people. Perhaps they might give some thought. See, we should ask the question, why not hear the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the biggest miracle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? What happens to my heart? Does my heart get affected by the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that if the words came down on a mountain, this mountain would crumble from these words. What impact does the words of Allah and the miracle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have on my heart? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described this book, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. He says, وَالْقُرْآنَ الْعَظِيمِ, this great Qur'an. And he said in Surah Al-Baqarah, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِي هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. This is a book where there is no doubt, a guidance for those conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And subhanAllah, you find that all books have errors. And after a certain time, the book becomes invalid or irrelevant or needs to be updated, etc. However, the Qur'an, subhanAllah, was a miracle at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and is a miracle until today. Until today, this book of Allah is a miracle. No contradiction, subhanAllah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us about the importance and about the reward of having an attachment to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. عن ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا حسد إلا في اثنتين رجل آتاه الله القرآن فهو يقوم به آناء الليل وآناء النهار ورجل آتاه الله مالا فهو ينفقه آناء الليل وآناء النهار. That there is no envy except in two things. You're allowed to be envious of a person whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given Qur'an, and this person reads the book of Allah during the day and during the night. And the other person that we can be envious of is a person whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given plenty of wealth, and this person spends the wealth for the sake of Allah during the day and during the night. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us the benefit and the reward of reading the Qur'an. He said, مَنْ قَرَأَ حَرْفًا مِنْ كِتَابِ اللَّهِ فَلَهُ حَسَنَهُ وَالْحَسَنَةُ بِعَشْرِ أَمْثَالِهَا لَا أَقُولُ أَلِفْ لَا مِيمْ حَرْفْ وَلَكِنْ أَلِفٌ حَرْفُ وَلَامٌ حَرْفُ وَمِيمٌ حَرْفُ. Subhanallah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us, whosoever reads a letter from the book of Allah, he will get a good deed. And the deeds are multiplied by 10. And he said to clarify, I do not say that Alif Lam Mim is one harf. However, Alif is a harf, Lam is a harf, and meem is a harf. SubhanAllah, there is so much reward, so much reward just by sitting and reading the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu qala anna nabiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala inna Allah yarfa'u bihadha al-kitabi aqwama wa yada'u bihi akharin. Umar ibn Khattab narrated that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevates the status of people because of this book and he debases others because of it. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us, khayrukum man ta'allama al-Qur'an wa 'allamahu, the best of you is the one who learns the book of Allah and teaches it. SubhanAllah, my dear brothers. You find, unfortunately, in our day and time, the Qur'an has become something ornamental in the home. A nice big frame on the wall. For some others, it just sits on the shelf, or in the glove box, or hangs in the rearview mirror. And today you find most Muslims spend more time on the internet. They spend more time reading the newspaper, spend more time watching television. SubhanAllah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warned us. He said, إِنَّ الَّذِي لَيْسَ فِي جَوْفِهِ شَيْءٌ مِنْ الْقُرْآنِ كَالْبَيْتِ الْخَرِبِ, that the one who does not have anything in his heart from the Qur'an, from the words of Allah, is like a deserted house. Look at the imagery that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is giving us, my dear brothers. It's like a deserted house. We all must have something from the Qur'an in our life. All of us must have a daily dose of Qur'an in our life. My dear brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Qur'an, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا. Then do they not reflect upon the Qur'an? Or are they locks upon their hearts? Subhanallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us and warns us in the Qur'an about the person who neglects this book. The Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam complains to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment about the people that have abandoned this book. He says, وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّ إِنَّ قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا. And the messenger has said, O my Lord, indeed my people have taken this Qur'an as something abandoned. SubhanAllah, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. We must have a plan to memorize the Qur'an, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to get the book of Allah in our heart, off by heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِنْ مُدَّكِرِ. He said this four times in Surah Al-Najm. He says, and we have certainly made the Qur'an easy for remembrance. So is there anyone who will remember? Subhanallah. On the Day of Judgment, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us, يُقَالُ لِصَاحِبِ الْقُرْآنِ اِقْرَأْ وَارْتَقِ وَرَتِّلْ كَمَا كُنْتَ تُرَتِّلْ فِي الدُّنْيَا فَإِنَّ مَنْزِلَتَكَ عِنْدَ آخِرِ آيَةٍ تَقْرَأُهَا. On the Day of Judgment, you will be called and told, start reading the Holy Book of Allah and ascend the high stages and levels of heaven and recite slowly as you had been reciting and reading in the world, as because your abode or your last level will be at the last verse that your recitation will end. SubhanAllah, wallahi, this book is a miracle of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, he says, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبُّرُونَ الْقُرْآنِ وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. Do they not reflect and ponder upon the words of Allah, upon the Qur'an? And had it been from anyone other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they would have had found so much contradiction. So much contradiction. SubhanAllah, you find this book was revealed over a period of 23 years. But there is not one piece of contradiction in the Qur'an. This is what, from its miraculous nature. There is so much miraculous things about the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that even until now they make scientific discoveries, and then the Qur'an spoke about this 1400 years ago. SubhanAllah, you find just recently they found that there's been traces of the Red Sea being split. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us a story a long time ago. He says, وَإِذْ فَرَقْنَا بِكُمُ الْبَحْرَ فَأَنْجَيْنَاكُمْ وَغَرَقْنَا آلَ فِرْعَوْنَ وَأَنْتُمْ تَنْظُرُونَ. And recall when we parted the sea for you and saved you and drowned the people of Fir'aun while you were looking on. SubhanAllah. My dear brothers, the book of Allah has historical miracles. You find that in the same place, in the land of Egypt, when Yusuf alayhi salam was there, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَالَ الْمَلِكُ اُتُونِي بِهِ. وَقَالَ الْمَلِكُ اُتُونِي بِهِ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that at the time of Yusuf, there was a malik. And at the time of Musa alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what does he say? He says, قَالَ فِرْعَوْنُ وَمَا رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. That at the time of Musa alayhi salam, the leader or the ruler was called Fir'aun. And if you look back in the history of Egypt, you find that at the time of Yusuf alayhi salam, the land was ruled by a king. And at the time of Musa alayhi salam, the land was ruled by a Fir'aun. SubhanAllah, even historical miracles in this book. My dear brothers, there is even geological, and sisters in Islam, there is even geological miracles in this book. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, غُلِبَتِ الرُّومُ فِي أَدْنَى الْأَرْضِ وَهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ غَلَبِهِمْ سَيَغْلِبُونَ. That the Romans have been defeated in the lowest land on earth. And they were defeated 7 years after the revelation of the ayah. SubhanAllah, fi bid'i sinin. And if we look at the geological aspect, miracle of this verse, you find that the lowest altitude on earth is the place where the Romans were defeated. SubhanAllah. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, there are scientific miracles as part of this book. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَنَّهُ خَلَقَ الزَّوْجَيْنَ الذَّكَرَ وَالْأُنْثَى مِنْ نُطْفَةٍ إِذَا تَمَنَّى. He talks about the scientific miracles of creation, and that He creates the two mates, the male and the female, from a sperm drop when it is emitted. SubhanAllah, and science, modern science, keeps finding new miracles that have been proven about in the Qur'an a very long time ago. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالسَّمَاءِ ذَاتِ الرَّاجِعِ, by the sky which returns. SubhanAllah, you find that the sky returns rain. It turns rain. And the sky also, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, returns radio waves that reflect off the ionosphere and travel around the world. SubhanAllah, that's how we have communication. And there are so many miracles of this book, my dear brothers. The embryo, you know, the development of the embryo of a baby. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in this book, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ سُلَالَةٍ مِنْ طِينٍ ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُطْفَةً فِي قَرَارٍ مَكِينٍ. That we certainly did, we create man from an extract of clay. Then we placed him as a sperm drop in a firm lodging. ثم خلقنا النطفة علقة فخلقنا العلقة مضغة فخلقنا المضغة عظاما فكسونا العظام لحما ثم أنشأناه خلقا آخر فتبارك الله أحسن الخالقين. Then we made the sperm drop into a clot, and we made the clot into a lump of flesh, and then we made from this lump bones, and we covered the bones with flesh, and we developed him into another creation. So blessed is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the best of creators. And subhanAllah, if we look into any modern science book today, you find that this is exactly the stages of development of an embryo into a baby. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, there are so many miracles, even literal, grammatical miracles within this book. You find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the word Makkah and Bakkah in the Quran, both referring to the holy place, the holy city where the Kaaba is. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used the word Bakkah, which means in Arabic, Bak comes from a place which is very congested. He used the word, and then the following verse talks about Hajj, as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is setting a scene for us to think about, you know, that this Quran has themes in it. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about congestion and a very busy place, He talks about Hajj, subhanAllah. And the place where He talks about Mecca, He does not mention Hajj. SubhanAllah, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has literal and figurative, you know, in this Quran has given us literal and figuratively accurate descriptions. He says in one of the ayat, ما جعل الله لرجل في قلبين من قلبين في جوفه. ما جعل الله لرجل من قلبين في جوفه. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not put for a man two hearts within him. And then the rest of the ayah, He talks about أزواجهم أمهاتكم. He speaks about the women, the wives, the mothers. But you find that if you think about what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is meaning, He's talking figuratively. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not put two hearts within the one person. The person can't have a heart of iman and a heart of kufr. It's either that or this. You can't have a heart of faith and a heart of hypocrisy. It's either this or that. However, you find that this verse is even literally accurate. Because that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not put two hearts within the one human, then this would not be literally accurate when a woman is pregnant, because when a woman is pregnant, the baby inside of her also has a heart. So subhanAllah, this verse is both literally and figuratively accurate. And you find that this precision that humans can't even think of when they speak is present in the Quran. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about the benefit of this book. He says, طه ما أنزلنا عليك القرآن لتشقى إلا تذكرة لمن يخشى. That we have not sent down to you the Quran to be distressed, but only as a reminder for those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is so much reward for reading the Quran in Arabic, even if you don't understand the words. SubhanAllah, you find Ukrimah ibn Abi Jahl was illiterate. He used to grab the scrolls of the Quran, and he used to cry and point to the lines and point to the words and cry. And he used to say, هَذَا كَلَامُ رَبِّي هَذَا كَلَامُ رَبِّي. These are the words of my Lord. These are the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, اقرأوا القرآن فإنه يأتي يوم القيامة شفيعا لأصحابه. Read the book of Allah, because on the day of judgment, this book will come for you as an intercession. Subhanallah. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, this miracle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the words of Allah, are a manual for our life. They are the street directory to guide us through our life. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called it the furqan, the criterion which separates haqq from batil. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمْ, that indeed this Qur'an guides to that which is most suitable and gives you good tidings to the believers who do righteous deeds, that they will have a great reward. And subhanallah, one of the most beautiful things about this Qur'an, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, is that this Qur'an is a therapy. And you find that most people have tried all types of therapies. All types of therapies. We go to so many, we go to doctors, we go to physios, we go to hydrotherapy. Some people have even tried retail therapy. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلَا يَزِيدُ الظَّالِمِينَ إِلَّا خَسَارًا. And we send down of the Qur'an that which is healing and a mercy to the believers. But it does not increase the wrongdoers except in loss. Subhanallah, just reciting the Qur'an, memorizing the Qur'an, having a connection with the Book of Allah, is in itself shifa'un wa rahmatun lil mu'mineen, healing and mercy for the believers. And subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the best of examples in this book, in the Book of Allah. My dear listeners, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَقَدْ صَرَّفْنَا فِي هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ لِلنَّاسِ مِنْ كُلِّ مَثَلٍ, that certainly we have diversified in this Qur'an for the people of every kind of example. وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ أَكْثَرَ شَيْءٍ جَدَلًا, yet man has been the most prone to dispute. Subhanallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the best of stories in this book. He says, نَحْنُ نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ أَحْسَنَ الْقَصَصِ, that to you, O Muhammad, we relate to you the best of stories. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that the stories in the Qur'an are the best of stories. He's telling us that this is where the Muslim should derive his stories from and seek benefit and try and reap the rewards and reap value and benefit from the Book of Allah. He's saying not from Hollywood, not from Bollywood, yet from the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The best of stories are in the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, you find that the story of Musa's mother, beautiful story, we all know the story, yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us something, teaching us certain values about yaqeen, having trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this Book of Allah. He says, and you find that the mother of Musa was so concerned about her young child, Musa alayhi salam, that she was concerned that Fir'aun is going to kill him. And we all know the story. But listen to the ayah, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals to the mother of Musa. He says, أَنِقْذِ فِيهِ فِي التَّابُوتِ, throw him in the box. فَقْذِ فِيهِ فِي الْيَمْ, throw him in the Nile River. فَلْيُلْقِهِ الْيَمُّ بِالسَّاحِلِ يَأْخُذْهُ عَدُوٌ لِي وَعَدُوٌ لَهُ, and this box will travel to the shore of the river, and his enemy and my enemy will take him. وَأَلْقَيْتُ عَلَيْكَ مَحَبَّةً مِنِّي وَلِتُصْنَى عَلَىٰ عَيْنِي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing us a miracle. This miracle, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, it defies logic. It does not make sense that you know the outcome. So you put your child in the box and you put your child in the river, the box in the river, and you know that this box will arrive at your enemy's doorstep and your enemy will look after your child. Subhanallah, subhanallah. But look at the reward. When the mother of Musa believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believed in the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what did he do? He says, إِذْ تَمْشِي أُخْتُكَ فَتَقُولُ هَلْ أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَىٰ مَنْ يَكْفُلُهُ فَرَجَعْنَاكَ إِلَىٰ أُمِّكَ كَيْ تَقَرَّ عَيْنُهَا وَلَا تَحْزَنْ وَقَتَلْتَ نَفْسًا فَنَجَّيْنَاكَ مِنَ الْغَمِّ وَفَتَنَّاكَ فُتُونًا. Your sister went around asking, would you like someone to look after this baby? After Musa, فَرَجَعْنَاكَ إِلَىٰ أُمِّكَ كَيْ تَقَرَّ عَيْنُهَا, and we returned you to your mother so her eye can be pleased with you, pleased with seeing you. وَقَتَلْتَ نَفْسًا فَنَجَّيْنَاكَ مِنَ, even you killed a person. You killed a person, ya Musa, but we saved you and we protected you. And subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us in the story of the mother of Musa how to have full trust on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't trust logic. Don't trust common sense. No, trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is what we need to derive from the stories when we read the Book of Allah, read the stories in the Quran. We need to derive themes that teach us values, how we should connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah, you find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us a story of Yusuf alayhi salam in the Book of Allah. وَشَرَوْهُ بِثَمَنٍ بَخْسٍ دَرَاهِمَ مَعْدُودَةٍ, they bought Yusuf alayhi salam for very small amount of dirham, very, very small amount of dirham. But what happened to him? When you find when Zulayqa, the Mra'atul Aziz, the wife of the Aziz, tried to seduce him, what did he do? He says, قَالَ مَعَاذَ اللَّهِ إِنَّهُ رَبِّي أَحْسَنَ مَثْوَايِ. When Yusuf alayhi salam feed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and feed sinning against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's commands, although he had all the conditions set out for him, all the conditions were perfect for him to commit this sin, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he feed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do? What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do? He goes to the prison, he spends some time in the prison, and he says, قَالَ رَبِّ السِّجْنُ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا يَدْعُونَنِي إِلَيْهِ. Oh Allah, the prison is more beloved to me than what they are calling me for. Yusuf alayhi salam, my dear brothers, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches us the moral of the story here, that when you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevates you. And this same person that was sold and traded as a slave for a few dirhams, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him ala khazain al-ard, made him the treasurer of the land, made him the treasurer and put him in such a high rank that his family came and prostrated him. Subhanallah. Prostrated him, of course, as a mark of respect. But this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevates someone who fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is what we need to extract from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We look at the story of Zakariya alayhi salam. Ya Zakariya, إنا نبشرك بغلام اسمه يحيى لم نجعل له من قبل سميا. Oh Zakariya, we give you glad tidings of a child, of a young son. His name is Yahya. We have not given anyone else this name. So Zakariya, who was an old man, his wife was barren. قال ربي أنا يكون لي غلام وكانت امرأتي عاقرة وقد بلغت من الكبر عتية. Oh Allah, how is it that I can have a child and my wife is barren and I've reached old age? Subhanallah, this is defies biology, defies physics. We all know that if a man gets to an old age, if a woman becomes barren, then it's pretty much impossible for them to have a child. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling me and you in the Quran, in the book of Allah, that we must have trust on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And things happen by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not by logic, not by physics, not by biology, not by chemistry. These are all creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says what to him? He says, قَالَ كَذَلِكَ قَالَ رَبُّكَ هُوَ عَلَيَّ هَيِّنْ وَقَدْ خَلَقْتُكَ مِنْ قَبْلُ وَلَمْ تَكُنْ شَيْئًا. That this is easy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I have created you from before, ya Zakariya, and you are nothing before. Subhanallah, we learn from the story of Zakariya, we extract something, a trust on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where we have more trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than in the asbab, in the reasons, in the logic. Of course, we must take within the reason. However, we must have trust on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these stories in the Qur'an, in the book of Allah, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, they teach us this trust on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to have a firm conviction on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah, look at the story of Maryam alayha salam. وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ مَرْيَمَ إِذْ انْتَبَذَتْ مِنْ أَهْلِهَا مَكَانًا شَرْقِيًّا. She took a place, a refuge away from her people. And then the angel came to her. Angel came to her. She said, قَالَتْ إِنِّي أَعُوذُ بِالرَّحْمَنِ مِنْكَ إِن كُنْتَ تَقِيَّ. I fear Allah from you, if you are righteous. Subhanallah. What did the angel say to her? قَالَ He said, قَالَ إِنَّمَا أَنَا رَسُولُ رَبِّكِ لِأَهَبَ لَكِ غُلَامًا زَكِيًّا. That I am the messenger of your Lord to give you a righteous child. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. She questioned, I mean, how can this be? قالت ربي أن يكون لي غلام ولم يمسسني بشر ولم أكو بغية. How can this be? I have not touched a man before, and I'm not of the low of women. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, is showing us. It's showing us His miracles, and He's teaching us values from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then she went off to another place, to a seclusion. And when the labor came, فَأَجَاءَهَا الْمَخَاضُ إِلَىٰ جِذْعِ النَّخْلَةِ قَالَتْ يَا لَيْتَنِي مِتُّ قَبْلَ هَذَا وَكُنْتُ نَسْيًا مَنْسِيًّا. And when labor came to her, she was at the side of the palm tree. And she said, I had been destroyed or something forgotten. Subhanallah, Maryam was so concerned. But look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comforts the person that fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam speak to her. He's a young infant, he's just born, but he spoke to her to reassure her. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala works. When you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَن يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. Whosoever fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him a way, a path out of problems, out of miseries. And listen to her, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks after her. He says to her, وَهُزِّي إِلَيْكِ بِجِذْعِ النَّخْلَةِ تُسَاقِطَ عَلَيْكِ رُطَبًا جَنِيًّا. And shake the trunk of the palm tree, and you will get some nice dates for you. Subhanallah. But, I mean, we look at this example and ask, what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make a woman who is in labor? You know, when she's so physically weak, so physically tired, shake the trunk of a palm tree. I mean, we've all seen how big and solid the trunk of a palm tree is. Even the strongest of men can't even shake it. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing us in this story that when you get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you move forward towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you try towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you the fruits. But you must make that effort. You must make the effort towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we extract from these stories, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, lessons, morals that we must be part of our life. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Aisha was asked, how was Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? She said, كَانَ قُرْآنًا يَمْشِي. That he was a man, he was a walking Qur'an. His akhlaq, his manners were the Qur'an. Subhanallah. This book of Allah, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, has the best of stories. Listen to the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam. إِذْ قَالَ لِأَبِيهِ يَا أَبَتِي. Look how he addresses his father. يَا أَبَتِي لِمَ تَعْبُدُ مَا لَا يَسْمَعُ وَلَا يُبْصِرُ وَلَا يُغْنِي عَنْكَ شَيْئًا. Oh my father, why is it that you worship something that does not hear, that does not see, and something that cannot protect you? Over and over, يَا أَبَتِي, يَا أَبَتِي, يَا أَبَتِي. And we look at the example when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands Ibrahim alayhi salam to slaughter his son Ismail. He says, فَلَمَّا بَلَغَ مَعَهُ السَّعْيَ قَالَ يَا بُنَيِّ يا بني إني أرى في المنام أني أذبحك فانظر ماذا ترى. I want you to understand and really contemplate the manner of dialogue between father and son. Look how Ibrahim عليه السلام addressed his father. يا أبتي, يا أبتي, the kindest of words. سأستغفر لك ربي. I will ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to forgive you, O father. Kindest of words, the way that Ibrahim عليه السلام addressed his father. Similarly, look how he addressed his son. He said, يا بني. Ya abati, ya bunay, ya abati, ya bunay. Look at the beautiful dialogue, the beautiful manner that the Quran is teaching us in how to address father and son relationship. Ahsan al-qasas, that's how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the stories in the Quran. Every single story, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, has morals and themes and things we can extract to use and practice in our every single day, in our lives. Subhanallah, this book, the words of Allah are so miraculous that whichever angle you look from, you find that there are miracles. Even from a numerical point of view, you find that the year is comprised of 365 days. And the word yawm, which is day, is repeated exactly 365 times in the Qur'an. And the word shahr, which is month, is repeated 12 times in the Qur'an. And the word sa'ah is repeated 24 times. Subhanallah. Whether it's historical, geological, numerical, scientific, grammatical, figurative, literal, miracles from every single angle. And subhanAllah, one of the things about this book, one of the miracles about this book is that people are able to memorize it. And you find that any of the scriptures, the scripture books, if they were to be thrown in the ocean, all of them collected and thrown in the ocean, the only one that can be recovered is the Holy Qur'an, the book of Allah, Al-Qur'an Al-Azim, Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem. SubhanAllah, so many miracles. We must have a plan to memorize the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The same way, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we have plans to go on holidays and to learn and to get new skills in life and plan for the dunya and plan for marriage and plan for so many different things. Each and every single one of us must have a plan to memorize the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi, it is, even if it is one verse per day or a couple of verses per day, whatever you're capable of, if you're unable to read the book of Allah, then you must have a plan to learn how to read. Learn how to read the words of Allah. And we know by the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that the one that stumbles and struggles in reading gets double the reward than the one who is very fluent in reading the Qur'an. So isn't that enough motivation for us to learn how to read the book of Allah? Memorize the book of Allah. SubhanAllah, we need to be at all levels with the Qur'an. We need to read the book of Allah. Memorize the book of Allah. Understand and read the tafsir of the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to contemplate and do tadabbur of the meanings of the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And of course, we must practice that what we know. And we must teach as well. خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. The best of you is the one who learns the Qur'an and teaches it. SubhanAllah, this book of Allah needs to be part of our life. every single day. I must have a plan to have a regular dose of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if it's a couple of pages. But we must not let one day go past without reading the book of Allah, without having our eyes look into the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How else would you then have a relationship with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if you neglect the book? Neglect the miracle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. SubhanAllah, sometimes you think and say, if I was there when Musa split the ocean, or when Isa alayhi salam was able to resurrect the dead, that would increase my iman. But can you imagine the miracle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Khatamun Nabiyyin, the best of creations? His miracle is the Qur'an. And it's still a miracle until today. SubhanAllah. But the only problem is that we've abandoned this book. We've left this book, unfortunately. We need to bring this book back into our life, inshaAllah. Have a plan to make this book part of every single day of our life. Understand this book, memorize this book. SubhanAllah, you find that any author that's written a book cannot narrate or tell you the book off by heart from cover to cover. However, this book can be memorized by young children, can be memorized by men, by women, of all ages. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِنْ مُدَّكِرِ, that we have certainly made this Qur'an easy for you to remember. So will there be anyone that will remember? SubhanAllah, they say, if you want to talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you should pray. And if you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to talk to you, then you should read the Qur'an. These, if we keep in mind that these are the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my creator, the one that knows me best, the one that knows how I work, the one that knows, he's given us a manual for our life, a solution to every single problem that we have. All of us have problems. Every single person has a problem. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us a solution to all our problems in this book. We just need to open the book, build a relationship with the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then we can find the answers to all our questions. All our questions have answers in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and sisters in Islam, let us make an intention, a sincere intention to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to make the book of Allah, the Holy Qur'an, part of my everyday life, part of my family's life. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who have a connection with the Qur'an, a connection with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those that act upon what they hear. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Until next time, thank you for tuning in. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Follow us on Facebook at the Deen Team Sydney radio program and subscribe to our YouTube channel, Deen Team Sydney.